In a time of global pandemic, we're being told to wash your hands, take your temperature, and keep your distance. It seems to me that these practices have a deep inner dimension as well. Take your temperature. Keep track of whether we're heating up with anxiety, heating up with anger, heating up with impatience. For some of us, I'm especially thinking of all the parents with young children running around their houses. Boy, the tension levels can just rise. And for us to be able to say, okay, my temperature's rising, I'm under a lot of stress right now. And just to name that, and maybe to say, you know what, my problem isn't that my kids are so bad or that my spouse is so terrible. No, my problem is just I'm stressed right now, and we're all stressed, and it's not their fault and it's not my fault. This is just a tough situation. Doing that kind of temperature check can be a good thing. We talk about washing our hands. I've tried to have a little prayer that I pray each time I wash my hands. And my prayer goes something like this. As I wash my hands, I ask that my heart be cleansed and purified from anything that could harm me, harm another person, or harm this beautiful earth. And so that becomes part of my daily practice of washing hands. And then keeping distance, we usually want to be close, we want to embrace, we want to hug, but keeping my distance is a reminder to myself that I have a certain power that I'm unaware of, the power to infect other people if I am unknowingly infected. And I think this awareness of our power is really, really an important practice for all of us. Whenever we enter someone else's presence, we have the power to bring them discouragement. We have the power to bring them fear. We have the power to raise their anxiety level because they're afraid we're going to judge them or correct them or pounce on them or find something to advise them about. What happens when we know our power? When before we rush in, we keep our distance and say, let me enter in this presence mindfully with an awareness of my power. Those are some practices that I think could help us in these challenging times.